Hey, what's up everyone? It's Derek with Nerd or Die, and I'm going to show you how to set up our free custom CSS for Twitch alerts to create some Overwatch-themed alerts. Let's get right into it. So we recently released some of the Overwatch overlays and decided to make some alerts that fit the overall theme. But you can use these for any stream design, of course. I'll even show you at the end how to customize these alerts just a bit. And in this tutorial, we're going to actually set up everything for Twitch alerts. So if you use muxy.io, I made a video for setting everything up in that system as well that you can check out in the description below. To start, head over to the Nerd or Die store and grab this pay what you want item. Please feel free to set your price to $0 and then proceed to check out to download the files needed. When you're done checking out, you'll be presented with a few download links, but the most important one will be the custom alert file. Download this file and double click it to open it up in your web browser or simply drag it into your browser as well. The file is a basic HTML page that contains code and helpful information about setting up your alerts. You won't need to know anything about HTML or CSS to set this up, you'll just need to do some copy and pasting. On the download page, you'll see a couple of things: written instructions on how to set up these alerts, HTML code on the left that will be your templates, and CSS code on the right, and some helpful links as well. Let's go ahead and walk through the instructions. For the alerts to look like the example that I showed at the beginning of the video, you're going to need to install the Big Noodle font that I linked in the description below, as well as the helpful link section, so you can click this to download the font. Let's go ahead and log into the Twitch Alerts account and click the Alert Box widget tab. Now, before we get started, I suggest that you take some screenshots or write down any of your settings, because Twitch Alerts does not have a reset to default button that I could find. Also, this type of customization isn't officially integrated, so it's sort of a use-at-your-own-risk type thing. For our example, let's go ahead and set up the follower alert first. Let's copy the follower alert message template from the page that we just downloaded. You can do this by clicking the copy button, or you can right-click inside the box and then hit select all and then copy from there. Now, let's go back into the Twitch Alerts page and replace everything in the message template with the code that we just copied. Set the text animation to none and remove the image from the alert. You can add in your sounds like normal. Let's set the animation duration to at least 8 seconds. In the font settings, there isn't much we need to change, but you can set the text color and the highlight text color to whatever you'd like. Let's go ahead and hit save settings. Next, we need to add our alerts into Obs Studio. It's very important to know that for this next step, we need to get the URL for only the alerts that we're going to be customizing with this CSS code. So let's pretend we're adding in these custom alerts for only followers and subscribers. At the top, under how to, make sure that only followers and subscribers are checked, and then copy that URL. With OBS open, add in a new browser source, paste in the URL that we just copied, set the width to 1920 and the height to 1080, and now go back to the webpage that we downloaded from Nerd or Die and copy the CSS code. Back inside of OBS Studio, completely replace all the CSS in the CSS override section with what we just copied. Let's hit OK to add it in, and now we can go and test this alert inside of Twitch Alerts by hitting the Test Follower Alert button. We haven't set up the subscriber part of these alerts just yet, so let's quickly go through adding in a subscriber and resubscriber message before talking about changing the background color of the alert. To do so, we're going to follow the same process as before, but this time let's use the code from the subscriber template area in the page that you downloaded from Nerd or Die. Once we're done with the settings for subscriber, we can add in a variation of this alert to set up the resubscriber portion. Let's call this variation resub and set the condition to months subscribed is at least, and then set 2 for the months box. Let's go to the page that we downloaded and copy the resubscriber message template, and then back in Twitch Alerts, paste it in, replacing everything else. We need to set the text animation to none, make sure no image is set up, and then pick the text colors that we want to use. With that done, we can hit save and then save settings again. Now we can actually test out the subscriber alert as well as the variation, which will already be added inside of OBS Studio since we copied the URL to include it. Again, I want to reiterate that we're overriding how everything looks with this CSS code. So if you have other alerts and Twitch alerts that you'd like to use, make sure you add them in as a separate browser source. In this example, we're adding in the follower and subscriber alerts. If we have other alerts using different settings, we grab the URL for donations and hosts and add it in as its own source inside of Obs Studio. This way, our custom CSS won't interfere with any normal alerts that you're already using. You can, of course, set this up for all the alerts that you like, and in that case, you'd only need one source using the URL with all boxes checked, and then override the CSS for that source in Obs Studio. The final thing I'd like to show you is how to change the background color of the box that appears for this alert. If you look at the message template code closely, you'll see a part at the beginning that reads style equals background and then RGBA 374874.8. This is basically what the box color is going to be. RGBA means red, green, blue, alpha, where alpha is the opacity of the box. So in the code, you'll see four numbers separated by commas. These represent the amount of red, then green, blue, and alpha. Since I have 0.8 here at the end, the box will be 80% visible, giving it a see-through effect. We can change this to 1 to make it 100%, or drop it to something lower like 0.3 to make it 30%. On the downloaded page, you'll see a color picker. You can use this to select a color that you'd like to use and adjust the alpha amount as needed. Then you'll want to copy the code for the color that you've selected. So we'd simply update the one part inside of the message template to change the color and then hit save settings. The most important part is to make sure that your color code looks like it did before. And if you need to go back to the default value, you can simply just refresh the page. With that, you should know everything there is that you need to know to set up your own custom CSS with Twitch alerts. And I had a few minor bugs along the way, so make sure to follow me on Twitter for any updates about this code, where I'll simply re-upload it and you can just grab it again if needed. But I think everything's working pretty well. Making something like this for Twitch alerts isn't the easiest thing, but I hope that everyone enjoys the final product. I'd also like to just say a very big thank you to anyone that's decided to support us with simply sharing our videos lately. It's been extremely motivating to see your responses to our latest videos, so I hope that we have even better stuff coming in the near future. If you have any questions about this video, please leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like and share this video if you found it helpful, and make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die for more great video game and streaming content. Thanks for watching.